proper course is 4 years because it's graduate only entry. So all applicants will already have a degree at 2-1 or first level. So if you don't mind the hard work, it's a good way to get through the course a little bit quicker.
We have to essentially get a 5-year course into 4 years. We don't cut a year off. We actually have to be clever in how we teach.
It makes it a lot more challenging in terms of time aspects. It really does put a pressure on you to push yourself to learn. You are really the one driving your own education.
It can be quite intimidating, really, but part of it is overcoming that, and I think the environment that we learn in is very supportive of that.
The backgrounds of students coming to the course are really varied. We now accept students from arts backgrounds as well as science backgrounds.
I study classics, which is Greek and Latin, literature, art, philosophy, all that sort of stuff. So very, very different. But I've also spent a year working on a stroke unit as an auxiliary nurse.
I worked in A&E for a year, which was a fantastic experience for me, but that enabled me to then go on and apply here and be successful. And I've taken the experience I've learned in A&E to my CBL group and to my own learning, and here I am.
Everybody's very motivated to be here. The sort of discussions that we do have, for example in the case-based learning, it makes those quite interesting and varied.
So when you go and see a patient who has Crohn's disease and you've learned about Crohn's disease from your Crohn's patient in block one, it's quite exciting. Then you can look back all over your stuff and see what happened with that patient, see whether it's different.
The early access to patients is just amazing because it puts everything into context and it really motivates you to want to find out what lies behind.
From very early on, from like the first few weeks, we went to a community health centre and we met up with some patients. We've seen some elderly people, some paediatric patients, people with chronic conditions. That's really, really good that you're introduced so early.
When they work with real patients, they realise that medicine is not like it is in the textbook. So a simulated patient might learn what the right symptoms are to say for a heart attack, but actually in real life it often isn't quite that easy.
Real people give you a genuine, honest answer. They're the people that you're going to meet when you go into practice. You know, they don't always give you the answer you want to hear, or it's not always the classic triad of symptoms that you learn in a textbook. It brings in the real life factors.
I go to GP every Wednesday each week. The idea is that I will take 3 consultations and receive feedback. We also watch the GP as they would usually do it. We get to go to an extended patient encounter each week, which means that we get to go and visit someone in their home and see actually how the disease or condition is affecting their life.
What we learn in the lecture theatre, I guess, is applied straight onto the wards, and we go around with consultants, they're pointing out what's happening here and what's happening there, and then you really do see a person with those things we're learning about.
I think skills like communication especially, they do take a while to develop. So by introducing it earlier in the curriculum, they've got more time to practice and perfect their skills before they use them as junior doctors.
Everyone here, we come as a big family and we're all now parting ways, and yeah, it's sort of bittersweet. So I've got my job down in Surrey at Frimley Park Hospital, which is part military and part civil. It should be exciting, I think it'll be good.
Initially I thought neurology because I spent 4 years doing neuroscience, but now I'm thinking more paediatrics, so it may change again, I don't know.
My first job is doing emergency medicine, which will be exciting, and hopefully everything that Warwick's taught me will be put in place when I start in August, so it's a very exciting time at the moment.